See, now you have said like, we need to connect with us, surfing to the websites and finding the relevant jobs or whatever the company details and all. So I'm taking this analogy, like the way you approach for your master's or PhD abroad, and the way you wanted to, you have to apply for jobs. I feel there is a similarity. What do you say?
Exactly. I couldn't agree more, because this is something that I've been telling so many people over the last 1 or 2 years, that it's the same thing. Like, you just have to do the exact same thing. The uncertainty is the same. Everything is the same. But
I'm like encouraging this point of view and the application time itself, because like the efforts I'm saying, many people like, please understand the process. Don't just ask somebody what to do, how to apply, and don't ask somebody. Please try to spend some time to understand the application process when you try for abroad studies. Again, the same process, you can use it for job search. So
exactly.
You may need to have cover letter, you may need to have a CV, or again, you need to find the company details. It is similar to like find a faculty of your research interest and find a research lab. Try to convince their relevance to with you with a technical explanation. And again, cover letter, which is similar to research proposal I'm comparing.
Yes.
So it is like almost like you are preparing to work in a different country, not just for studying, you are preparing for working also in a way.
Exactly. Yeah, I mean, it's exactly the what you've said is just so much on point. Yeah.
And again, I'd like to add a comment again, saying like, one thing, let's say some person is trying for somewhere studying abroad, like any other country. So they have studied. And again, they went for some selection and they couldn't get till the final. But the process, they can even, from their home country, they can still apply for jobs.
Yes.
Even for higher studies, you can still apply for jobs even with the same experience, the same efforts you can put. Now you learned the process, you apply for jobs also.
Yes.
So likewise, exactly. I think your off-campus happened the same way, right?
Yeah. I also, like I just said, we don't have anything like campus placement, so everything is basically off campus. So you look for jobs wherever you want or wherever you would like to go.
So I have come across the friends who applied for off campus job applicants and also the MS PhD applications. I'm being interacting with them. So in the interaction, I got a doubt, or it's a kind of observation you can call it. So can I say that the application process, the things you're learning for MS PhD abroad in other countries, and also the job applicants in MNCs in any other country is similar? Can I say that? So the answer could be yes, as per my understanding. Let me put up on the observation so that if somebody is relevant to you, or like you are aspiring for getting job in other country, you can also consider trying out. So the thing is that for MS PhD applications, what we basically do, we prepare our documents thoroughly, our transcripts and our CV and also our proposal, whatever relevant documents, we prepare thoroughly and we search the faculty details or the lab details where we are going to apply. That is very good. The similar way, job application also, it should happen the similar way as per the observation I have made. Like, you have to review the company details and the job description details so nicely. Here, the lab research is very important. The same way here, job description in the particular opening in the particular company is very important. You have to review it. Based on that, here I could say in place of proposal in MS PhD admission, here I could say the cover letter. So your cover letter should be as much as close connected with the job description. Even I have interacted with the recent applicant, he got succeeded in the application. Maybe that's the reason. So I'm just putting up the perspective so that it may be helpful. So it's like a cover letter, make it as close as the job description. Your half work will be done. And your CV, try to put more technical terms. So recently I have submitted one of the resume copy to one of the top recruiters in UK, just to see how they review the resume evaluation committee. So it is like the resume for jobs, there may be not sure that the person will be reviewing your application or the CV. Here the program or the machine learning algorithm will pick you a resume out of the bunch of applications. So that's what I came to know. That is What I mean to say that in the CV or the cover letter, when you want to apply for a company, you have to put more efforts to match as much as the technical terms of your background knowledge. That is a crucial point. And it's not mandatory. There are cases, even the, sometimes the people will be reviewing, the HRs will be reviewing the basic review, and then it will be sent to the technical manager of the particular opening. So it is a both ways. So still you can try. There is no hard and fast rule. And then the companies, you need to find out the relevant companies to you. That is similar to MS PhD universities, where you find your relevant research areas and the relevant universities, right? So it is similar. So here also it is similar. So I would like to make it like both are similar, and the person who can secure admission abroad, or you can who can work hardly about the processing documents for abroad application, he or she can equally try for jobs also. If you are interested, it is highly probable that you will get some good response. And another thing is that when you don't get responses for the mails for the faculty or the research group, what we have suggested you in the previous video, similar way, when you don't see response in the job applications or the industry applications, you need to revise your CV and resume when a discernment attitude, like you need to remove whichever is not relevant very seriously. So the same way you can use it multiple revisions. So either one or the other application definitely will undergo for the scrutiny. So you will have a high chances that you'll get a job or you'll get the interview call. So there is this observation. There is some more depth observation, which is in-person interaction with the industries or the job experiences, that will be shared later on. This is one perspective, so that it can be like a capsule for you people who want to try for job. When you can't get admission in because of some deadlines or some other things, you try the same approach, and you may get your confidence that how the company looks your profile, right? Like if the company says rejection, that means your profile is not up to the mark. When you are revising, you are making your profile look so stronger and so powerful. The same thing, it might be helpful for your PhD, or vice versa. So that is one observation I would like to say. So some more things I'll be adding in coming days, as and when we get the relevant observations. Keep following us. Please subscribe. Let us reach to the 1K subscribers, so that community portal will be activated. That will help us to reach more relevant people, so that we can interact with the post and the polls before making a video. That will be much helpful. Please do subscribe, and please share the videos to the relevant people. All the best. Wish you good luck. Thank you.